This is the tsunami caused by the Tohoku quake. Tohoku is the name scientists have given to the earthquake that hit the island of Japan in March of 2011. At a magnitude 9.0, it is the fifth strongest quake in recorded history. Many people lost their lives, and so scientists continue to study its dynamics in an effort to learn on how to better prepare ourselves for the next one.
No warning. The thing is, they just felt shaking. 2 minutes after that, or 1 minute after that, they heard something cracking in the mountain. And a minute after that, whole mountain came down.
Dr. Tiwari is an assistant professor of civil and environmental engineering at Cal State Fullerton. He recently traveled to Japan to investigate the geological effects associated with the quake and discovered that tsunamis are not the only catastrophic consequence of an earthquake.
Because so far, people think that, you know, earthquakes don't trigger that much landslide. But with Japanese experience, we see that they trigger big landslides.
Dr. David Bowman is chair of the Department of Geological Sciences, also at Cal State Fullerton. He recently gathered with other scientists and educators to discuss recent findings in the geological study of earthquakes.
Landslides are definitely a problem in Southern California. These beautiful hills and mountains that make it such an attractive and beautiful place to live, they fall down. What geology pushes up, gravity pulls down. And it does it from earthquakes. And we know that there are landslides during earthquakes here. In the 1994 Northridge earthquake in the San Fernando Valley, that did trigger a whole series of landslides in the mountains.
So what are we supposed to do with all this information?
This is your opportunity to think about what you would do in an earthquake. If there was a disaster, do you know what to do? In an earthquake, you're sufficient for yourself. And that's what we really hope people can do, is to look at themselves and make sure that they're prepared to stand on their own for a period of days to weeks.
These are just some basic essentials that everyone should have in their emergency kit. It's good also to keep them all in one bag or container so that you can just get up and go when you need to. Also helpful to keep one at work, at home, and in your car if you can. And always remember to keep cash on hand. If the power goes out, your ATMs and credit cards will not help you. As scientists continue to study the causes and effects of earthquakes, we can all learn from the lessons of past quakes and prepare for those to come.
The one thing that we can really say about seismology and earthquakes is every time we think we got it figured out, nature does something that we didn't expect. And that's scary, but it's also interesting because it means we're learning more.
For the Daily Titan, I'm Lisette Guzman.